Make sure you watch this video to the end because I'll be telling you the cons of living in Rancho Mirage. Okay, the first pro to living here is the weather. It only rains here about 14 days a year. Can you imagine that? I have people calling me from Washington, Oregon, even people in Maine, people on the East Coast to move here because in January, February, when you guys are shoveling snow on the East Coast, we're here sitting by the pool. Yesterday, it was 80 degrees and we're in the month of January. It's crazy. I want to show you a weather chart so you can see what it's like to actually live here all year long. Okay, here we are. You have the average high and low temperature for Rancho Mirage. Now you could see, here in the winter months, going into November and December, average is 68 degrees and the low is 45 degrees. And that low at 45 is mostly at night. It rarely gets like that during the day. Now if you go into January, February, March, the average is 76 and the low is 51. So you could see it's pretty amazing here in the winter months. Now going into summer, it's still in the 80s right here going into 90s. Now we have 4 months here that get pretty hot and we're gonna go into that more later in this video. But other than that, it's pretty incredible. I mean, where else can you have 80, 70 degree weather in December, January, February, March? So because of that, the second pro I want to tell you about is the lifestyle. The lifestyle is incredible in a big part due to the weather. We have so many amazing outdoor activities here, such as tennis, such as golf, such as pickleball, racquetball. I mean, the list goes on. With all these sports also come some amazing tournaments, such as the tennis tournament that's world class. Rafael Nadal, Roger Federer, they come here in Indian Wells at the tennis tournament. We have world class PGA golf in La Quinta. Music festivals like Stagecoach, Coachella. I mean, International Film Festival in Palm Springs. So there is stuff here, not only in the winter months, but also spring and summer. There's stuff going on. So that's why lifestyle is number two for pro, because I think nothing could really beat this place. And the third pro is cost of living. Now I know what you're thinking, Tommy, cost of living? How is that a pro? You live in California. Well, California compared to the rest of the US, it's very unaffordable. I mean, let's just be real. Let's put it out on the table. But if you're looking to live in California and you don't want to pay those California high prices, well, Rancho Mirage might be the place for you. Now, Rancho Mirage is higher price per square foot than a lot of cities in the valley, but it's still affordable than cities like Los Angeles, San Diego, San Francisco. So for that reason alone, I have a lot of people leaving major cities in California, being able to work remote and that sort of thing, moving here to the Palm Springs area, cities like Rancho Mirage, because of the affordability. Let's check out this cost of living calculator. And if you're interested in a fuller video on cost of living, check this video out right here. I think you're gonna like it. It will give you the whole rundown. So here we are, cost of living calculator. Now you could see moving from Los Angeles with a salary of $50,000 to Rancho Mirage, you could decrease it to 40,000. Now, the biggest thing with cost of living in California, the biggest factor, I guess I could say, is housing. Housing's gonna be the biggest difference between these cities. Let's take a look. Housing, it's 25% less to live in Rancho Mirage than LA. The median home cost right here is $689,000, basically $700,000. In Rancho Mirage, it's $500,000. And let's be real, LA, to have a nice house in a safe area, if you're in like West LA, it's gonna be over $1 million. So it's almost half as expensive to live in Rancho Mirage, which is the playground of the celebrities and presidents, than LA. So it's pretty crazy. So if you're looking to live in California, Rancho Mirage is a good place to be. Now the fourth pro is location. Now I'm gonna talk about Rancho Mirage's location in comparison to the Palm Springs area, and then we're gonna look at it in comparison to living in California overall. Now Rancho Mirage is right next to Cathedral City and Palm Desert, and it's not far from Palm Springs. Now what I like about it is you're still sort of central in the valley. Let's take a look at this map right here. So here we are. So you're still like central in the valley, but you could get to Palm Springs or the Palm Springs Airport in 10-15 minutes, depending where you live in Rancho Mirage. Then you have all the great shopping and dining here at El Paseo, which they call like the Rodeo Hills of the desert. So we have a Gucci store, Louis Vuitton. It's actually right out my window here. So you have all that in your fingertips living in Rancho Mirage. It might be a 10, 5-minute drive, 15 at the most. Rancho Mirage has the river where you could go see a movie or go to the Cheesecake Factory if you'd like. Rancho Mirage isn't a great location, and it's just one of the safest, I have to say, in the Palm Springs area. Now, let's look at Rancho Mirage compared to California. Now, living in Rancho Mirage, maybe sometimes you're gonna be like, well, I wanna get out of the desert, maybe go somewhere. Well, look at this, right over here to the left, LA is about a 2-2.5 hour drive in San Diego and Mexico, but San Diego is a 2-2.5 hour drive. So living in Rancho Mirage, you get to be in California, but not have to spend the expensive high living costs. And say you wanna go up to San Francisco and in wine country, man, maybe a 12 hour drive, an hour plane flight. So it's really convenient being in Rancho Mirage, not only for the Palm Springs area, but also for the rest of California getting around. Now, before we start the cons, most of these pros and cons are from what I've heard from people living here, from people visiting here, and my personal experiences, so this might be different for you. But the first con is the weather. Now, if you remember, the first pro I talked about was actually the weather, but it could be a con as well, and let's take a look at our weather chart. Now, most of the year, the weather here is beautiful. As you could see, it's very mild in the 70s, 80s. You know, you don't have to worry about snow, shoveling snow, whatever. I don't even know what snow is living here. But seriously, if you could see in the summer months, 107 in July is about the average temperature, and it gets a little hotter than that. So what my family and I like to do, I have a beautiful wife, I have two children, an 11-month-old and about a 2.5-year-old. I don't even know what age they are anymore. They grow so quick. I'm sure some of you would know. So living here, when it gets a little too hot, there's about a month maybe or a few weeks where it's like unbearable. Then you could either stay indoors or you could go to the beach. I mean, with a two-hour drive, we sometimes go to the beach, stay a couple weeks, get out of the heat, and it's great. And you have that option here. Because let's be real, if the weather wasn't like this in the summertime and if it was 70s, or even 80s all year long, the price, the cost of living here would be double because everybody and their mom would wanna live here. This is like, it would be even more the place to be. So thank God in the summertime, it gets a little hot, it keeps people away. But for real, I live here full time and I love it. I have a video actually about that, what it's like to live here full time. And it's great. I mean, we don't really mind it. I mean, sometimes in the summer it's tough, but we could go to the pool until it gets maybe 110, 120. 12, 115 out, and then we're like, okay, no more pool days. But those days are far and few between. So the weather, that has to be a con just because sometimes we do get that extreme heat, so you should know about it. Now, the second con is that it is a small town. I mean, you could get from Palm Springs in the left side of the valley, the west side, to the east side being like Coachella, La Quinta in maybe 35, 40 minutes. So that's tiny. You could get around here like that. But that's some of the appeal. A lot of people are moving here because they want to move out of the hustle and bustle of the larger cities. So if you're looking for like a crazy wild nightlife, you're not going to find that here. But we do have like the Nest. It's in Indian Wells. It's open to like one or two. That's probably the wildest it gets here in like the Palm Springs area. But other than that, we have lots of great restaurants, things to do. But nightlife, you're not going to be like clubbing and that kind of thing, you know? So if you do want that, LA, San Diego is not far away, but you know, it's a smaller, sleepier kind of town, you know, just, yeah, that's it. Now the third con would be there's not a lot of jobs here, and let me preface that. Now the biggest industries we have are tourism, agriculture, healthcare, and then education. Now let's take a look. Now, if you just look at Palm Springs, there's 194 hotels in Palm Springs. I mean, just look at this huge list. And that's not even counting Palm Desert, La Quinta, Rancho Mirage. There's probably over 1,000 hotels. There's tons of restaurants we have, lots of just tourism, hospitality kind of jobs. We have many casinos like Agua Caliente, and just the list goes on. So if you're looking for that kind of job, we have that. healthcare. We have Eisenhower, JFK Hospital. So we do have a lot of healthcare kind of jobs and a lot of senior living homes. So that might be an option for you as well. Agriculture. So if you look in a map of the Palm Springs area, Thermal Mecca Indio, we are one of the largest producers of agriculture for Riverside County. So there's plenty of jobs in that industry as well. Last industry is education. We have a lot of public schools and private schools. So if you're looking for a job in that sector, there's lots of opportunities. I want to thank you for sticking with me watching this video. If you haven't, hit that like button for watching this whole video. Subscribe if you want to learn about the area weekly. And if you want to learn more, I have tons more videos on my YouTube page about the Palm Springs area. And also, you might be thinking about moving here. I have people calling me all the time watching these videos wanting to move here. My email, phone number, everything's down below, so please reach out to me. I would love to help you. And thank you again. I appreciate it. Maybe I'll see you here soon. Have an awesome day.